In this video, we're going to be finding the determinant of a matrix. Now, I know you're probably wondering what this is and why should I even care, but I have to tell you the determinant is very important and we will see exactly why in the follow-up videos, but for now, we just have to concentrate on actually calculating the thing. So, and I'm going to show you a couple of methods for different matrices because, for example, there's going to be one solution for a 2x2 matrix. It's going to be completely different for a 3x3 matrix. And there's yet another way for a 3x3 matrix that you can apply to 4x4, 5x5, etc. So hopefully you'll never have to do that. And I really wish you not to see anything bigger than a 3x3 matrix. But it is good to know how to do those things and we will practice. So first things first, let's start with this matrix A. It's a 2x2 matrix, nothing you haven't seen before. So how do we calculate the determinant of that? Well, pretty straightforward it is. So the determinant of A, it could be written like this, det A, or also like this, equals to, lo and behold, it's AD minus BC. There you have it, that's the determinant. Things are not going to be that easy usually. So let's right away go ahead and look at a 3x3 matrix B that we have over here. And let's say determinant B equals. And how do we calculate this? So in order to calculate the determinant for a 3x3 matrix, we need to take one row or one column. It doesn't matter which one. It could be the first column, second or third. Same goes for the rows. But what I suggest you do is you take the one where the coefficients are the smallest. For example, 1, 2, 3 is quite attractive, but there's something better. We can use this, the second column, which has a zero in it, and that simplifies things greatly. You're going to see why in just a second. So let's start by taking this first number in the second column. And what we do is we cross off the row to which it belongs and the column to which it belongs. So, and what this results in is we have this smaller 2x2 matrix, and I'll just write it below. So it equals to negative 2 multiplied by this 2x2 matrix that we get when we cross off the row and the column to which this number belongs, and it's 4, 6, negative 7, and 9. So we have this first item. And just bear in mind, this thing, the 2x2 matrix that we have multiplied by our negative 2 is called the minor of this item or of this number in the matrix. So in the same fashion, we're going to find the minors for 0. We're not going to do it for 0, but you would find it for the second term, and then you would find it for the third term, which is 8. So here things are much simpler because whatever you multiply by 0 is just 0 anyways. And another thing that's very important to remember is that the matrix has to follow a certain pattern. So when you calculate the determinant, and it can be written like this, for this matrix, it's positive, negative, positive, negative, positive. So it's kind of like a chessboard, in a sense, that you have alternating positives and negatives. And if actually I take a look at it, it seems like this is going to be, the first term is negative, so it has to be multiplied by negative 1. And now let's add the second term, which is a zero, of course, and it's supposed to be positive, but it's just zero. And we have our last negative term, and it's 8 multiplied by whatever is going to be the minor of this term. So it's 1, 1, 3, 4, and 6. And what this gives us is now it's a much, much simpler calculation. We will calculate right now negative 2, actually just 2, since we're multiplying by negative 1, multiplied by 36. So this minus this minus negative 42, or just plus 42. Plus 0 and minus 8 multiplied by 6 minus 12. This gives us 78 times 2, or 78 times 2, or 156 minus 8 times negative 6. Or 156 plus 48. And that gives us 204. Voila, we just found the determinant of matrix B. As you can see, nothing complicated. Things to bear in mind is this. Small, you know, what do you want to call it, matrix of symbols, positive negative matrix, and the rest is pretty straightforward. You just cross things off and you find the determinant. Thank you for watching our video. Stay tuned for more math topics and don't forget to subscribe.